Hello and welcome. My name is Robin and you're watching A Robin Reads. Today I wanted to show you my updated bookshelf. Shelves. Because this is my in-between period between moving and not moving. So therefore I have a whole new setup for my books, and I thought it would be a nice idea to show you how I set it up and what kind of books are on my new bookshelf, so you know a bit of what I'm going to read the next couple of months. We are moving in October, I think, so between now and then I'm reading all of these books probably, and I'm making that a priority because I don't want to bring all these books with me to the new house. And yeah, let's get started basically. So what I'm first going to mention is the pile over here on the bookshelf itself. That is the pile that I got for the books I'm going to read this month. You've seen these in my May TBR, yes. This is the little flower pot I use for my bookmarks. And yeah, then let's get started and I will show you the rest of my books. So this is shelf number one. As you can see, I put all of my books in color order. So, like a rainbow. I really, really am liking it. So, therefore, I will be doing this in my new room and the newer house as well. I will show you that video when I am going to make those bookshelves. But yeah, these are all the books. Before I Go to Sleep by S.J. Watson. The One You Really Want by Jill Mansell. A Dutch book named Gezien de Feiten by Giet op de Beek. Scarlet Feather by Maeve Binchy. Star by Danielle Steele. Sonny Boy by Annette van der Zijl. A Man Called Ovi by Frederick Backman. De Ooggetuige by Simone van der Vlucht. Murder Most Unladylike by Robin Stevens. The Boy in a Dress by David Williams. Beetle Boy by M.G. Leonard. Lone Wolf by Jodi Picoult. A Monk's Guide to a Clean House and Mind by Shokai Matsumoto. Robinson Crusoe by Daniel Defoe. An Anonymous Girl by Greer Hendricks and Sarah Buchanan. And yeah, those are all the books. As you can see, there are a couple of library books. This one, and this one. I put them here because I don't want to have a separate pile for them. The libraries are opening in like a week, I think. So that's really, really great. And yeah, just those are all the books on this shelf. Then going down, I have my series shelf. So here I have The Guardian Cycle by Julia Gray. So The Jasper Forest, The Crystal Desert, The Red Glacier and Elissa's Ring. And then over here I have the Earth Children series. The Valley of the Horses, The Mammoth Hunters, The Plains of Passage and The Shelter of Stone. There are missing two books from this pile because the first one is my on my TBR up above there. And this one, the first one, I've already read. And this is the place for A Dance with Dragons, but I'm currently reading that one. So that is this shelf. Then onto the bottom shelf. We have here Eleanor and Park by Rainbow Rowell. Een Tafel vol Vlinders by Tim Cabé. Eating Animals by Jonathan Safran Foer. The Boy in the Striped Pyjamas by John Boyne. Lisa's Adem by Karel Glasra van Loon. The House at the End of Hope Street by Menna van Praag. Brainwash by Carrie Slee. Four volumes of the AI Love You series. It's a manga series. All the Lies We Cannot See by Anthony Dower. De Wetten or The Laws by Connie Palmer. The War of the Flowers by Ted Williams. Manga Messiah by someone. I can't see the name of the author. This is the manga version of, the creation story of Jesus, basically. Brida by Paulo Coelho. And Het Duister Dat Ons Scheidt by Renate Dolsteyn. So, as you can see in this whole shelf space, I have a lot of blue books. So, what I'm going to do is a challenge this month, and I'm going to read blue books for that challenge. This is an idea that I got from the channel Chelsea Darling Reads. She does this mainly like every month, she tries to do it, and she reads books that are the one color. And she has a rainbow shelf, so therefore she does this. And because I have quite a lot of blue books, I thought, why not do that as well? And I'm putting it out here, so I will make that video and show it to you guys. But yeah, this is my sort of little bookshelf that I have. And yeah, now going on to my other shelves. So those shelves I got over here, this is sort of an overview. And up there I have some DVDs. And as you see, can see, I put these in color order as well. Let's begin at the top. So these are all the books here. Here in the corner is The Collector by John Fowles. Then A Brief History of Time by Stephen Hawking. Hitman Anders and the Meaning of It All by Jonas Jonasson. I, Slayton by David Lagercrantz. De Woongroep by Franka Treur. Jonathan Unleashed by Meg Rosoff. The Wind in the Willows by Kenneth Graham. Gardens of Delight by Erica James. The Woman Who Went to Bed for a Year by Sue Townsend. Till We Meet Again by Leslie Pierce. The Storyteller by Antonia Michaelis. Tell Me Lies by Jennifer Crusie. Hatchet by Gary Paulsen. Holes by Louise Sager. And Odessa Star by Herman Koch. So that is this shelf. Then going on to this shelf, beginning at the left again. De Zee in Lied by, I think, Slauerhof. De Komst van Joachim Stiller by Hubert Lampo. Bind by F. Bordewijk. An Untamed State by Roxane Gay. De Nachtwandelaar by Marianne Fredriksen. Het Geheim van de Schrijver by Renate Dolsteyn. Another Jennifer Crusie. This one is Anyone But You. Monoloog van iemand die het gewoon werd tegen zichzelf te praten by Dimitri Verhulst. Maan en Zon, a.k.a. Moon and Sun by Stefan Brijs. How to Be Good by Nick Hornby. Child 44 by Tom Rob Smith. Two Agatha Christie collections, the second Fiveling and the third Fiveling, with both have five stories in them. Blue Water by Simone van der Vlucht, and these are all Nicky French books. And I think The Memory Game, The Red Room, The Safe House or something, and Lost. So yeah, those are all the books on this shelf. As you can see, or maybe you have seen these books a lot in my book hauls and stuff, because I really want to prioritize books I have recently bought so they don't stand on my shelves for years, as has previously happened. So therefore I put a lot of books that are new on here so I can read them as soon as possible. And just also books I'm really excited about and really wanted to read for quite some time. And also a lot of Nicki French because I have a lot of books by them. And yeah, just want to read probably like one a month if I can manage that. So yeah, those are these little shelves. And these are my DVDs. So yeah, I think they really look nice. The color pattern is pretty nice. And yeah, therefore, I just really want to do this in my new room as well. So yeah, those were all my bookshelves. So those were all the bookshelves I want to show you today. Those are all the books I have still got in my room, basically. And these are the books I'm going to read the next few months. So let me know down below if I made the right choices. Did I, just have the right books on my shelves? And yeah, that's basically what I want to show you today. So you have kind of a little overview of the books I still have. And yeah, I really hope you liked this video. Please give it a thumbs up, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you later.